stuff on it, the sealer. Yeah, it's not broken anymore. Let's see which way it went. Not even 100% sure. I think I might have it right there. Let's see if it could go the other way. I don't think it could. Yeah, it's got a bunch of nice tabs. Kind of would like to just put sealer on one side so that I could take the bolt off again. Oh, it goes either way, I think. Let's see. It's hard to tell which way it might have been on before. If it goes either way, I don't guess it matters that much. That has a bit of a ridge. Oh, and that has a keeper area. Yeah, I think it went like this before. I don't believe I had any trouble with it leaking. I mean, I would like to not. You know, as easy that is to get on and off, I might. This is the side that looks like it needs. No, that's the side. That side looks like it might actually need a little help. So I'm going to put some on that side. On the other side, I may not. I'm going to squeeze a little. Take it. Look it over. I don't want to get a little out of here because this has not been used in a while. Yeah, that's probably a little hard. I don't think I have it. Yes, I do. I do have paper towels with me. Yeah, let's lay things on the carburetor. Yeah. Let's not. Okay, now. Let's not lay things on the carburetor. We can don't and say we did on that one. Let's dump and say we did. That's what they used to say to me when I was a kid. And I used to say, that doesn't make any sense. What are you saying? And they say, don't be smart. Smack you. Okay, yeah. So. Just want to kind of support it a little bit. And I want to go kind of try to get it. Okay, so. This side I'm going to put some on, the other side I won't. That way if I need the bowl off, it will be stuck and ruin my gasket. And if it does leak, then I still have the option of putting some on the other side. I got a bunch of it. Get up there and gum up a jet or something. I heard water dripping or tinkling, I was like, what? Because I'm leaning hard on this hose. I think I'm squeezing it one way or the other. I don't know, right here, right? It makes it sound like it's leaking, but it's not. I'd rather not get it on my fingers. I can keep from it. So I'll wait on that part right there until the very last. A little clump right there waiting for me to get with my cutting knife. I knew I needed that. So I think we can shut that. We're gonna be all over the place. Now, usually I wouldn't bother if it's doing this, but since I don't want too much, I'm gonna kind of spread it just to can thin it out, and even kind of away from the inside. It's gonna be any little wiping is just gonna be wiping off. I don't, you know, it probably doesn't actually need it, but since it was a little few paces peeling off there on that particular side, I think thought it might help. I used to always use that stuff no matter what. I wouldn't believe them. Well, I learned it the hard way. Back in the, I actually started working on cars when I was about 12 years old, my mom's car, but my first car I got in 1972 or 3, worked on them ever since. And anyway, they would say, oh, you don't need any gasket sealer on this, don't put this sealer. Yeah, they didn't believe what they said every time. And so I learned not to listen to that, those instructions. Some of it will probably get on the front side anyway. It's not going to get torn or broken when I shove that bowl on there. Well, that little spot did break with that one. That's on the inside where it's not actually sealing anything. That's just kind of, I think, to keep it from tearing it apart. The corner's breaking out as usual. Okay, there we go. Now if we can get this off my fingers. Ready to go on the next step. Throw you on the ground. Oh, somebody will pick that up later. That would be me. Okay, that somebody would be me. Yeah, I really need to get those leaves out of there. They look terrible. Maybe you can't see them. That whole valley there under the wind, above the windshield is full of leaves. Okay, now, where's all my bolts? I don't think they were dirty, really. Oh yes, bolts and new parts. Wiping the old dirt and if there's any gasket sealer or anything left on those from the previous. There it is. Now. I'm probably need to try to double check the tightness of the base, but I'll do that once I get this back in there. Okay, everything looks good. Well, it ain't stuck. Solar pump seems good. Nothing has been leaking, so. Actually, I think I'll put it on here. Yeah, okay, let's show a close up of how it goes on there. A little bit of rubber sticking out. So, should be able to just slide it on up. There's a little. You know, the actuator for the chiller piston. How does it piston? That way. So how does it go? Oh, it goes under this? Slide it on there first. Yeah, it goes under that. So you got to pay attention to that. Is this going to fit? Yeah, you got to really pay attention to that or you have a pain. You got it all bolted up. I probably did that before. Seems familiar. You want that actuator from the linkage on top of that. Yeah. Okay. Start putting in the bolts. If you put it in the right place, it'll work better. Usually. Not always. Okay, let's see. I got my ratchet, better get my nut right. I can turn them by hand pretty good. I guess I can snug them up close enough by hand. I like to use the easiest way though. I usually use the nut rubbers and stuff. I've got them handy. Well, I am going to need those big old wrenches because I'm going to take that off and put some sealer on that. Well, I mean, it looks like it's going to seal. It felt like it was, you know, fairly tight up in there. I'm going to go crisscross. Although, I'm going to just do them all a little bit at a time because I want to be able to kind of make sure it's in the right place before I really start cinching it down. With small bolts like this, you're probably better off using a quarter inch ratchet so you don't break something. It's easy to get overzealous with these smaller things and break them. Especially for some people, they don't seem to have any outside to break something. Sometimes it's hard to tell. I'm not going to tell that you're over tightening and breaking strips, especially aluminum. See, this is an aluminum carburetor. Well, then the bolts aren't aluminum, but they're not just plain old. I don't know if that they're brass. They're not brass, but they're not. So something that rusts really easy. I can see that. Of course, they're in aluminum, not steel. But those long bolts like that, they make that little noise. I don't know if you can hear the little flexing noise when you tighten. Be careful. Yeah, that's as much as I'm going to do it. Okay, now that one is it's a little bitty one. It's the only thing you can use. And it came with it. It's a pain to. Yeah, my solar pump works. That's good. So, yeah, I'm not going to just put that back like that. I'm going to. I'll get my big wrenches that I could have left there on the, and used. Needed them. I knew I needed them. I need to stretch my legs out a little bit anyway. Still have my gooey stuff. Okay. I want to put a little bit of that gooey stuff on. Ow. Some of these tools that I'm done with. Okay, now I'm gonna put my old part over here. Yeah, I need these after all. I also need some. Oh, I think one of those will do that. Got this. I'm gonna put that on there. Get these before they blow off. Let's see. Yep. I think I've got what I need to do this. Hopefully. Oh. Okay, now. Unless this one of these wrenches is not the right size. It's pretty good. Well, that's the biggest one I got here. The biggest one I got looks too big. It's a 3/4. I think I ended up having to use something like a metric. Yep. It is in between 3/4 and 5/8. So I gotta go back and get a different wrench. Ow. Well, that's weird looking. It looks like my screen is fogged up on the right side. Huh. Still recording. I don't know. The first one I grab might be it. Let's check first. It's not very tight. Let's see if there's one below it. didn't think that this was made in, well, none of my other stuff on here is metric. That's just a weird size. 18 millimeter still feels too loose. Let me go see if I got anything in between that and American. Here's 11/16, let's see what that's like. That's more, well, it's about the same. Anyway. No, that's way tighter. It's 11/16, folks, it's American! We're saved! American Carburetor Company, dang sure better be using American sizes. American measurements. Okay. There we go. Okay, so this is the inlet. Fuel inlet. Flange, whatever. It's a weird design. It's neat that it's adjustable. It's not neat that it's prone to come loose and leak. Always has been. Can't put a seal. Wait a minute. There's a seal in there. It's really, really old. Well, no, I probably replaced it. Yeah, I probably replaced it. When, is there one on the inside too? Yeah. Okay, so there are seals. But anyway, it needed a little help. I thought it did anyway. See, I got me a new paper towel. For cleaning stuff. And I'm gonna put a little. It's dark up in here, I can't see. Let's don't put anything down the carburetor. That stuff is stuck on there pretty good. It doesn't want to come off. Get my utility knife. Yeah, it just fills up the rest of the area with. Ooh, that seal came off. We don't want to lose that. That is on there so good, I hate to peel it off. I can't show it up here on the camera and do this, so sorry. And I couldn't stand bending out that way either. Yeah, I got new seals for it when I got that carburetor kit. And I don't believe I saw anything like that in there just now. I don't know about you, but I'm getting a little tired. It's not super bad, though. I came out, well, I meant to come out here and start working at 7. I knew I would take a little time setting up cameras, but I didn't get out here till about 8. Because about the time, I got up at 3, but by the time it was time 7, I was like, man, I'm going to have to eat lunch or I'm going to collapse before I get finished. So, I'm a diabetic, so I have to time everything out. And, so yeah, the seal is a little black seal. I'm not gonna let go. I'm not gonna even try to lay it flat in my hand or anything. And there's the thing. Gotta pay attention to which way's which. Okay, there's a seal on the other end. Oh, okay, there's only one side that you can put that seal on, I think. I thought it had a lip on it. Doesn't. Well, the one I just got through cleaning the heck out of. I need to clean it a little more. I thought the. Now I don't know which side's which, but they're not really all that different except for. One side doesn't seem to be as flat. It seems like it has a little ledge on it. It could be a wear ledge and not a. judging that by what I see of the gasket sealer and everything, but actually that was probably because the seal made it do that. So I will squirt it with a little cleaner or a little starter fluid or something just to clean it off. I'm having to lean way back here and get a little spot with a little light so I can see what I'm doing out from under the hood. I don't want any of that old sealer in there. I'm going to get that off and then put some new in there. This front seal, the outer seal, I don't think it'll come off. I was going to say, it almost looks like it has, yeah, there it goes. It almost looks like it's made of metal. It is. Are they both metal? They're metal. I wonder they don't seal good. Uh-oh. Where did it go? I'm laying them on my gloves because I thought it'd be a better place to keep them clean, but now it went somewhere. Put it down in a better spot. I think it just went between the fingers. Hope it didn't hit the ground. Not to be. There it is. No, that's the one I laid there. There it is. Guess the gloves are in a good spot. Okay, so. Yeah, they're identical seals. So these are metal. So I doubt they've been replaced. I think they're the same one. But they definitely didn't seal very good until I put seal on. Okay. Where did the little screw go? There it is. Yeah, I wanted to clean out from the other side of it. This is brass, I think. Magnifying glass in my light. We're gonna look it over. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, so they're identical. So it doesn't matter which side I put what. There it is without any old seal. That one wore. It's like a washer almost. Has a hole in there that goes into. I think you can see it. Maybe, there you go. Comes in from the fuel inlet. And this allows the fuel to run through it into there. Definitely have to get that from Holley if you lost that. Okay, so I'm going to put some. I was going to spray it, but it doesn't need it now. I got it clean. Put some sealer on it. Okay. I would do it up there by the carburetor, but I'm afraid I'll drop it somewhere and just drop it in a dirty spot or down the carburetor or something. So I'm going to have to do it out here. I'm trying to get it in a place that doesn't hurt to set. Ouch. Again, I don't want too much of this junk because we don't want to. Where's that? Need my cutting knife. Okay, yeah. I can kind of spray. spread it out without it being all over the place. Because we don't really want to feed any into the jets on the carburetor. This stuff would last forever. It would just stay there. Oh, there's one of those little bees. Now that I'm up here and don't have my defenses. It's the first one I've seen since I've been out here today. It's not a bee, it's a wasp. Actually, it's not yellow. Well, it's kind of yellow. It's a dark yellow and brown, light brown, like tan or something. I guess that's kind of a regular wasp color, but it's going down in the grill. At least they're not mad yet. Get out of here! Usually if you blow at them, if you get your breath on them, they'll go away. They don't usually like that, unless they're in a bad mood. Okay. I would have thought that poison would have killed them all. Phone's dinging. Wait, sometimes I have the volume up, sometimes I have it down, I never really know where I have it. You have to turn it up all the way to hear. There's a weird noise going on over here. You have to have it up all the way to hear the Okay, now I gotta put a little. I'm gonna figure out where to set this stuff. To hear the video, when you make a video, yeah, I'm gonna have to hold this like this. Right here. Can't see it from either camera, can you? I'm sorry. Go away! May have to go get the poison. But if there's more of them and you kill one, then they usually come out and fight. If they don't bother you, then you can just let them kind of buzz around. Usually. I'm hollering at him to go away, but he thinks I'm at his house. That's where he took up residence. This is really hard to get in the right place. It's so slick and kind of small right there when I'm trying to put it. Oh, I guess I'm leaning on that. That's where that noise is again. It's while I'm leaning on the water hose and radiator, and it's making noise out the vent on the other side. Yeah. Making noise over there on the I think I'll put a little bit on the other side of that seal. I have had so much trouble with these things just dripping just a little. And then see, that's what was the thing I kept thinking was leaking too. There's this thing right here that I'm working on. Keeps coming back over this way, just kind of meandering around, and if I blow at it, it goes away for a little bit. As long as there's only one, I'll probably let it run. Okay. Yeah. Make sure everything is still there, that I'm not missing any parts. Come on, line up. get a hold of that stupid nut. Neck or whatever it is. There. Just want it pretty well straight. I was wanting to start it and show it, but you know, I want that to dry before I give it any gas. So I'm going to leave it till tomorrow. Tired anyway. I'd be happy to just get it back together. Sometimes they go around behind me and it makes me nervous because they'll go land on my head, crawl around in my hair, and get in my neck. Trying to mess with my mind. Never have stung me in the back. They always go for your eyes. They get to one where they want to sting you. They go right for your eyes. I got stung almost in the eye one time. Cause I was playing around we were working on my friend's car over to his house. They like my shampoo, the Aussie. I like that Aussie shampoo, but so do the beans and stuff. Anyway, they was digging around in my hand. It kept going and moving around. And I said, one of my friends is an avid photographer. And I said, hey, take a picture. And so I stood still for a little bit, and everybody was yelling and laughing. And all of a sudden, that thing went out faster than I could blink an eye, and came towards my eye, and I closed my eye, and it stung me. And I was way up in town, eye swelled up, couldn't hardly see. And I had to sit around there for two or three extra hours before I could even see to drive home. And it was a hot day, and I was outside working, and I was tired, and I wanted to go. Yeah, I didn't feel good after that. I did take some Benadryl, and that helped a lot. But. Okay, so. Now, let me look over my, I think it was a wasp. It's pretty soft, so it's pretty new. And I don't think I destroyed it getting it off. My what? I'm not lying. Yeah. So I think I can put it back on there, alright? Here's the I usually don't use. I did it. Let's see. I just used that. That's a quarter inch. That holder. Where's it? That's what I used to get it off. But it's not. It's aluminum, so I don't want to mess it up. So I'm going to put an actual quarter inch nut driver in there. Okay, am I ready for that? Accelerator pump works. There's no fuel in it, so you can't get it to pump up. Let's see. Yeah, I'm ready to put that on. It's nice and long, isn't it? Let's see. I was thinking that having like that got in the way of the air cleaner, but I guess not. I think that's how it was. Yeah, but this is the weirdest. It doesn't hold good when you drop it. So. But that's why I don't want to wallow it out anymore. Let's make sure it's tight. So. Oop. If you can spin it, it's not tight enough. It fools you sometimes. Whoa. And neither is that. That's one reason why I always put sealer on that and then let it dry now because. Oh, come on. Give me a break here. That must be a little bit bigger line than. It's hard to get on that. I mean, I'm having to squeeze down on that. Oh, I stripped out my gym. I gotta get a new hose clamp. It's stripped out. Dang it. I'm gonna see if I can tighten that. You can't hardly tighten that with the hose on there. You can't get the wrench on it. I thought I had that good and tight. Hose clamp is. I'll just unscrew it all the way. Like that. I can get it off. Now I'm gonna tighten that. Okay, now. that's pretty, I don't want to overdo it and break something. Once that stuff dries, it should be alright. It's that gas, former gasket. It didn't leak before, I had it all sealed up. Those metal gas, those don't seal. Look at that. They don't make hose clamps worth crap anymore. Still hadn't let go yet. I hardly ever throw anything away, but that's going in the trash. Okay, I gotta go get one out of the toolbox in the truck. I keep spare parts in the truck. Okay, we'll be back. I might spray that. If I see that wasp, I'll spray it, maybe. That's like lifting weights. Oh, man.
Cameras more you can see what's going on and probably hear what's going on. But anyway, about to get finished.
Wasp comes back. I sprayed the grill a little bit. If it comes back, I won't be able to reach that.
just where I'm reaching. So I really need it. Okay. Okay, where's that? I got a new one and an old one, so if the new one's a piece of crap and it breaks, then I'll put the old one on there. As long as it ain't wore out and broke. Or if it ain't big enough. I don't know, I think they're both about the same size. That's big enough. That other one looked really new, so I'm pissed that it broke. Recording. Yep, still recording. I imagine as long as it's been, these things have worked as I hoped, and they are starting over when they get to whatever the maximum file size is for that phone. I think it's 3.5 gig. Might be smaller than that. So that's what was wrong, why it kept not tightening up, because the clamp was slipping and I couldn't tell. Well, it's still not tightened up yet, though, is it? I'll just kind of hold that with that. And I can twist on it as I go. Ooh. I don't know why it doesn't want to tighten up. Maybe that hose is too old. Is that cracked? I may need to put a piece of hose on there anyway. Yep, there's a crack down on the other end. So all that time is wasted. Piece of hose. I'll get a new piece. I got some new hose in the back, in the toolbox. I kept having a feeling I might ought to replace it. I just didn't want to. I didn't want to go through that much trouble. And used to, I wouldn't until they were really, really looking old. But this gas just eats up these seams in a heartbeat. So if you see just a couple of cracks, it'll be through to the inside in no time. This is usually the end that's hard because it's not very long. Hard to get to seal. It's a different kind of hose, I think, from what I have down here. Maybe older and just harder. It doesn't feel all that hard. Though, it's a good size. That's 3/8. That's what I need for those to fit over them. Gotta go in the truck again. Oh.
Oh, we'll just do this. There's a wasp. I think it took off though. I'll just do it. Stick it on like I usually always do. I'll stick it on one end and I'll figure out which one fits it best. These are some new stuff that are supposed to handle ethanol good. Oh yeah, that's too big. So this one ought to work here. I think I'll put my hands on there now. Let's see. Put them on there now. I think I'll cut them at the end off. It's a little bit. And I won't need it on there. Yeah. It's a long stem, but I don't care. I'm going to cut it off where it's straight. That's the best way. Use wire, big, well, those are cable cutters. That's the best way to get a good straight cut. They're rounded a little bit, even. Actually, I was most likely they were made for cutting those. They're actually cable cutters. The bigger cable instead of just small wire. There we go. Now, just leave that like it is until we get a length cut. Now this thing, I want it to be one up too high. But you really don't want it rubbing on that. When the motor vibrates, you don't want it rubbing on that air bracket either. Think about right there. Let me get my cutters ready. Yeah, about right there. Yeah. Okay. There we go. Where's my nut driver? Yeah, it shouldn't take a lot of force to get these things tight. But that's good. Putting the holes on there. That one's a lot bigger. I don't have any WD-40 up here. Maybe this will do it. All I need is to lubricate it a little bit. Put my glove on so that if it slips, I won't be taking all the skin off my knuckles. WD-40 is what I usually use to get these lubricated so that you can get them on there. Oh, that one's a lot bigger than the other one. I gotta get some WD-40. I think I can do it with the WD-40. Well, it's a good thing that I kind of worked around the garage and did a few projects before I started this. This is a killer for me. It's a lot harder to crawl and up and do all this stuff than it is to do a lot of other things. cans up here. Okay. Yeah. Maybe I can get out of there. Shove it up in there as far as you can because it's going to squeeze back off a little bit. That was too short. I like those. No, wait, I'll put that one first. I like those, you know, glass filters, but they're too short right here, and they're just a little bit too big around there on that flange. On that connector. Yeah, that's a lot softer. I think it's gonna stick better. Get my pliers to make sure, but I believe it's there just fine. Yeah, it's not spinning or anything. I didn't check my filter and see if it was tight. I think it is. Shoot, what'd I drop? It's not my pliers, at least. That's what I need. Okay, that seems fine. I mean, it hasn't been leaking or anything, but I don't know what fell, but I'll worry about that later. Just looking to make sure that's tight before I go on to the other one. If I can get that other one to be not spinning, then I'll be good. Let's see what we got. I think maybe it'll tighten up this time. It broke. It's really, I mean, I'm having to tighten them, but they're failing is what they're doing. They're starting to grind out metal, and then used to didn't have them break on you like that.